Dr. James Wanika, Vice President of the Republic of South Sudan. Right Honorable Speaker of the National Legislature, Honorable Presidential Advisors, Honorable Ministers, compatriots, ladies and gentlemen, I want to thank each and every one of you for attending this important meeting to brief you on the decision reached by the Presidency yesterday in regard to the number of states, which has just been read out to you by the Minister in the Office of the President. As we gathered here today as the transitional government of national unity, I want to remind ourselves of the sacrifices that our martyrs made to liberate this country. And for that reason, we are bound to take any decision that is deemed necessary to preserve the unity of our country. By doing so, it signifies that their precious blood was not just shed in vain. This decision was reached by the Presidency after weighing several options, and we thought this latest compromise will preserve the unity of the country and move the people of South Sudan out of this imposed, senseless conflict, which has affected the livelihoods of many of our citizens. For the last 6 years, we must put a stop to this suffering because our people deserve the best. For close to 2 years now since the signing of the revitalized agreement, the opposition forces have been holding our country to ransom because of the issue of states, although this was not the reason why they took up arms against the government in 2013. For such unnecessary demand, we have not been able to form the government as stipulated in the agreement. Two deadlines have already been missed, and another one on February 22nd is looming. Yet our people continue to suffer due to intransigence of the opposition. I am aware that there are some people who may think that we have relented to the pressure of the opposition, but this is not true because we realized the goal of the opposition is to ensure the country remains unstable in order to continue putting the blame on the government. Comrades, ladies and gentlemen, the compromise we have made today is one of the painful decisions I have ever made, but it is necessary. But it is necessary if that is what will bring back peace and preserve the unity of our people. I have been fighting throughout my entire life for the liberation of this country. And I will always stand against the forces that aspire to destroy our hard-won sovereignty. I will not accept to preside over the destruction of the same country that I sacrificed to liberate. The insistent demand to return the country to 10 states is a strategy of the people who do not wish us good but more suffering and destruction. My decision today will throw out such ill intentions and make us resilient against their mischievous plans. We were in the 10 states when the war started in 2013, and that attests to the fact that the cause of this conflict was not about the states, but mere greed for political power. Comrades, ladies and gentlemen, I call upon all of you, the citizens of this country, especially those who may not be comfortable with this decision, to accept it and rally behind your government. To implement the revitalized agreement, we should refocus our energies to the unity of the country so that the peace agreement that we are going to implement reunites our people once again and gives us the opportunity to collectively embark on the nation building. As liberators of this country, we should always take decisions that are in the best interest of our people and the country, to the best interest of our people and the country. And this is what I have done today. And as you have read in our resolution, the issue of the number of states will be addressed by a revitalized transitional government of national unity during the implementation period. We will make sure that the people of South Sudan are accorded an opportunity to exercise their rights in determining the number of states that they need in the country. Yani ya jama kalam betal walaya de da haja basit jiddan nanu gidamna anamol constitution. In that constitutional process we can determine the number of states and also after the election. Should that come after the elections, these conditions of confining us to conflict will not be there any longer. And we will go back to whatever number of states that we won. Let the people not let their hearts be broken, because 10 states will not cover old South Sudan. Let us move forward. At this juncture, I would like to commend the security sector for upholding their constitutional mandate of protecting the territorial integrity of the country and maintaining law and order. I further urge them to continue observing the permanent ceasefire as the exert, as we exert efforts to ensure timely information of the revitalized transitional government of national unity. I implore the international community, particularly the UN, IGAD, AU, EU, and the Troika, to recognize the major compromise that we have just made today. I appeal to them to support the implementation of the agreement, both morally and materially. For without their support, their contributions, we may not be able to meet the daunting task of reviving our economy and set the country on the path of development. Comrades, ladies and gentlemen, the world is watching us, and I once again want to redraw your attention to symbolic prayers conducted by the three Welsh Christian leaders during our retreat to Rome in April last year, particularly the action of the Holy Father, Pope Francis, kissing our feet. As I reiterate on a number of occasions, this is a blessing to us if we are sincere in our efforts to reunite our people and salvage them from current suffering. Or it may be a curse if we continue to pursue strategies that endanger the lives of our people. We need to pay attention to this because the curse may not only be upon those whose feet were kissed, but could also be all of us who make decisions on behalf of our people and this country, and so the need to implement the agreement requires our collective consensus and efforts to resist the temptation of going back to war. Comrades, I can't end these opening remarks without equally appealing to our brothers and sisters who are still holding out to come and join us on this journey of reuniting the country. The compromise we have just made is in the interest of peace, and the quest for peace should not be one-sided. I expect the opposition to reciprocate the same and allow the country to move forward. Thank you very much.